Thanks, Brian. Thanks, Brian, and I'm very happy to be given an opportunity to present the first US Million Dollar Korea Cup and on the protocol establishment under strict time constraint. And my presentation will be a more real life case than the scientific. And I may summarize the process. It is like constructing the railroad while the train is already coming. Before 2012, the KRA wanted to host the international race without any established protocol. So it was only in the document for the KRA's midterm future plan or something. And in February 2013, I was put to be in charge of the international races, the Korea and Japan host exchange races. I started to establish the protocol between Korea and Japan. And I was managed to establish the protocol just in time for ship horses from Japan to Korea. And finally, horses from Japan arrived in August, and we raced on 1st of September. And then Japanese horse won in Seoul, and then Korea horse won in November in Tokyo. So which became the driving force to proceed the international race in Korea. And I like to show the most recent Korean international race, which called Asia Challenge Cup. So the yellow cap cover from gate number 2 is the El Padrino, which was the defending champion 2014 of the Asia Challenge Cup. And this horse, the black cover, is the horse now in Dubai, the sprinter. And this horse, the one this race. Now El Padrino is coming from behind, from outside. And this is a typical running of El Padrino. When he ran fourth at the Gold Shaheen 2015 in Dubai. I think we were able to win this race because we changed the distance from 1400 into 1200. We hosted this race the 2014 with the 1400, but last year we make it this race character more sprint. So we changed the distance from 14 to 12. And if we had a race more than 50 meters, then El Padrino won definitely. And this is the location of the Seoul Race Course International Stable. When measured by GPS, this international stable is away from the local stable, 200 meters away from the local stable. And the other side, there's another local stable complex. This is the track and the grandstand. And let me show you the movie introduction of the Korean, the international stable. We have a two complex, and which is and whenever we enter the complex, we use the disinfection booth. So we instead of the shower and the getting changed. And this international stable is a 24 hours CCTV camera surveillance and double vector proof stable. We can accommodate horses from up to five countries. And inside of the stable also 24 hours CCTV camera surveillance. And here and there, all the entrance is from the isolated stable. Entrance to the track. And this is last year we built this new stable. Also we used the disinfection booth when we enter. And this is the inside of the, our the newly built international stable. Also double vector proof. That's the way from the stable to the track. And this is a timeline, how we established the protocol with Japan. We requested Korean Ministry to establish the protocol between Korea and Japan. And Korean Ministry sent official letter to asking for the protocol establishment the late February. But the full procedure was delayed because of the government reorganization after the inauguration of the new president. And in April, we finally managed to launch the consultative body with the Korean Ministry and the Quarantine and Inspection Agency and the Korea Racing Authority. And we had a face-to-face meeting in Tokyo with the Korean Ministry official and then Japanese Ministry official. And after that, Korean Ministry agreed with the Japanese Ministry's condition. And then the Korean Ministry announced the temporary protocol between Korea and Japan, inclusive of international stable was designed as the national quarantine station, and the racetrack was approved for training of overseas horses on the quarantine. And in between May and July, on the assumption that I could ship the horses from Japan to Korea, I proceeded the nomination and then the shipping contract, and I sent all the invitation to the connections. And temporary protocol was finally enacted between Korea and Japan 7th of August, and Japanese horses arrived 21st of August. And other than the protocol, we had difficulties with the moving horses from the air stall to the horse truck, because as I told you in advance earlier, we didn't have an international race. We didn't have a temporary condition for race horses. So whenever we imported horses, permanently import horses from overseas, the way we ship the horses from the air store to the quarantine station, because the quarantine station is only 5 to 10 minutes away by drive from the airport, so we use the forklift and then lift the air stall into the truck, then move the air stall itself, transferred to the quarantine station. But I had to have a difficult time to convincing the government official to open the air stall, and we need to move the horses from the truck air stall to truck. And finally, government allowed us to open the air store, but they insisted the tunnel system. And they raised the issue, their concern was that whenever the hay or straw from the store flying into the other area, then it can be the issues with the plant quarantine official. But this matter was settled the next year with the hosting of the equestrian event of the Asian Games. This is another timeline of the protocol establishment with Singapore. After the KRA successfully hosted the Korea and Japan exchange races, we started to invite the horses from Singapore. So in March, the Korean Ministry sent the request to the Singapore Ministry. And because when we established the protocol between Korea and Japan, we haven't experienced any independent risk assessment report. And all of a sudden, the AVA, the Agriculture and Veterinary Authority of Singapore, requested us the independent risk assessment report. So the Dr. Kenneth was recommended by the Singapore Top Club and accepted by the AVA. So I had to fly to Hong Kong to get some approval from the Hong Kong Jai Club whether can cooperate for the Korea matter. And KRA made a request to the Hong Kong, So finally we submitted the compiled the questionnaire and then the report to the AVA. And we had a consultative body meeting because the previous year when we established the protocol with Japan, there was 7 days of a PEQ, pre-export quarantine condition. And at that time, the Korean ministry didn't have experience with other countries, so we just followed the Japanese condition. So the condition was itself the bilateral condition between Korea and Japan, and in that condition, we had a 7 days PEQ. So I persuade the government to delete the 7 day PEQ, and we need to make a condition from bilateral into listed condition. And government accepted it. So after that, on the another assumption that the I could finalize the protocol in time for shipping horses from Singapore, early July, I had a kind of a presentation with the Singapore connections to nominate their horses to Korean international race. And 24th of July, the movement of horses from the air store into the truck was officially approved because the government realized if they keep insist the kind of a tunnel system with a cover on the ceiling, then it may not be widely acceptable for other countries' connections. And the 12th of August, the movable bridge was manufactured. But on the same day, it was a very embarrassing moment. The government official of the ABA, when we give them a call, because it was the day was scheduled to finalize a protocol between Korea and Singapore, but when he gave them a call, I was told she had an emergent maternal leave. So it was just only 10 days before the shipping date. So I was very embarrassed, and on that night, I climbed up the mountain and I thought to myself, where my life is going. Because we are kind of a semi-government body, so all the plan is strictly controlled by the government. And if we plan it, and if we don't make it, then the next year we cannot guarantee we can secure the budget and all the HR. So I was very desperate. So about 10 days, I lost all my conscience, and then I seek to the Korean ministry whether they fly to Singapore or to persuade the AVA whether they can make any replacement official as soon as possible. But finally, the protocol was officially announced 2 days before the shipping. So, and on the other side, I already issued all the air tickets for the connections. I booked all the accommodation and all the functions were made. So it was a very hard time for me. And the other side, horses arrived on the 22nd of August, but return protocol has not been finalized. So while they were in Korea, the return protocol was made. Probably I would have been happier if I keep very good three Singapore sprinters in Korea. But finally they made it, so the Singapore horses went back to Singapore. In 2015, we made the another protocol for Korean horses to enter Singapore and return to Korea. So we raced in Singapore in July 2015. And after this slide, I will show you the very, for me, it's very touching moment in my life, in my racing career. I finalized the protocol between Korea and UAE about 3 years, and then finally, one of the Korean bred horse ran third in Dubai. So after the Singapore protocol establishment with the Singapore initiated, we started to talk with the UAE. So the official request from the Korean ministry to UAE ministry was made in October 2014. And January 2015, UAE ministry, they replied to us and they suggested us the face-to-face meeting in Dubai. And at the meeting in late January, the all were happy and all agreed verbally. So I thought, I can make the protocol in time for the Korean international race in August. So we were very optimistic, and then Korean ministry sent official agreement letter in February. But however, the reply from UAE ministry, we didn't get any reply from the UAE ministry, and only I got the reply is from Dr. Tony Kettle in early July, that many suggestions were made from the UAE side. So I went to the Korean ministry to whether they can accept this many revision. And luckily, Korean ministry approved, accepted, and they sent all the agreement letter. And I was told later, the reason why the period was so long between February and July that the undersecretary of UAE ministry has been changed since we had a meeting in January. So there was no reply at all. And in July, from the July then, the Korean ministry was fully convinced they can establish the protocol. So in late August, the Korean ministry approved the UAE host for UAE host to enter Korea and return to UAE, not the return to UAE. So for UAE host to come to Korea. But after that, we wasn't able to finalize the protocol. So in November, we were told it could be finalized this year, 2015. So on the assumption that we can enter UAE, I applied 3 horses from Korea for the Dubai World Cup Carnival. And 8th of December, finally, officially, the protocol was announced. And then on the same day, the 2 horses were accepted for the Dubai World Cup Carnival. So we shipped the horse from 23rd December, but we used to have a direct cargo flight from Korea to Dubai. But when we finalized the protocol and when we arranged the shipping, there was no more direct cargo. So we had to ship the horses from Korea to Qatar, and from Qatar, there was no connection flight on the day. So our horses had to stay one night in Qatar Annual Lounge, and then they had to ship from Qatar to Dubai. So I had to spend the Christmas Eve on the road, waiting for Korean horses at the Dubai World Cup stable. But the moment, I still remember the time, 10:40 in the evening, when the horse truck gate opened, when I see the horse from Korea, I almost cried. Now, this is the race on last Thursday. Gate number 4 is the Korean bred horse named Success Story. It's a mile race.
And Karina's Success Story is burning through, looking for the lead as they leap to the draw's brother. Success Story in front of American Hope and Top Clearance now gathers pace to move to third. Vortex fourth, then Foxtrot on the inside, unforgiving minute.
He led the race all the way from the start to up to fourth last turn. White cap.
Success Story leads out the back, they left the first quarter behind with 55-1 and 847.6, so he's getting along.
I think Jackie didn't fully believe the performance of this horse. He had an early touch on the horse.
He's running third, they get away from Foxtrot. Then find that boy and just now to the outside, but it's a race in three. Success Story, flat of the bullets. 300 left to run. American Hope goes to him. Top clearance is still left away. American Hope putting it in front of Success Story. Top clearance is trying to reach him. American Hope takes 100 to go. Top clearance is still going. You get it. Top clearance. Grand American Hope. Well, have the rest. Top clearance. Different from the line.
The last year's Dubai World Cup, you know, was African Story. I really hope to follow the name of the Korean horse, Success Story, in this Dubai World Cup Carnival. It's the last week the rating condition was between 95 to 118. And then this horse rating, official rating was 100. And this is a actually, at the race, the second runner following the Success Story was owned by Godolphin. It was my dream, only in the textbook or the journal. So Godolphin color run overseas. But it's my kind of a dream made come true. Korean horse run with a Godolphin horse. Godolphin owned the horse with blue color. And I may say it was very brave run, and then from that night, my new dream just started. Whether we can go to Super Saturday. Because the margin was 2.25. So if this horse run again competitively, there's a small possibility. But small possibility makes dreams come true.
Yeah.
And now I'm still constructing the railroad for this year's Korea Cup. To make the Korea Cup more international event, the protocol establishment with France and UK and Ireland is on the way. And the health certificate for Korean hosts to enter EU is already approved in 2000. And Korean Ministry send the official request and the questionnaire in October. And I asked the Korean ministry whether they make the questionnaire simpler than normal. Because it's not fair. Already EU approved Korea, but Korea didn't approve EU. So I asked the Korean ministry to make the questionnaire simpler. And they accepted and they made it simple. And the questionnaire I was told is only 2 pages. And as soon as we get the reply from relevant ministry, then we will approve it very fast. And thanks to all the specialists around the world, say the Ireland, the doctor this is helping me to liaison the CBO of Ireland with the Korean ministry. And UK, the Department of Environment, Fisheries and Rural Affairs, we already responded to each other. And thanks to Louis Romane and Dr. Roland Bolt, they pressured the France Gallop, and France Gallop, they are contacting the French ministry. So I also, on the assumption that I can ship the horses in time for Korea Cup, I already started to talk with the French and the Ireland and the UK connections, whether they can send their horse to our international race. And Hong Kong, Hong Kong very fast. So I just started to talk with Hong Kong from late last year. And Korean ministry sent a questionnaire, the formal questionnaire to Hong Kong, but they already replied. And this morning, when I prepared this presentation in the room, I got the email from the Korean ministry. They finalized the answer to the AFCD. And then it will be sent early next week. So I believe we can get the horses from Hong Kong. But we race on sand. I don't think we can get many good horses from Hong Kong, but anyway, there's a dirt horse from Hong Kong. So, and then the most exciting thing is that we just to think about to invite horses from Hong Kong, but there was a request from the members, about 25 members, they would like to book the private room at our grandstand. So it's a kind of a, I may say, the veterinary science makes people happy. Now I can say the Korea's the KRA's international race plan like this. Up to last year, it was only a local G3 race, Asia Challenge Cup, and we were able to invite the horses from only from Japan and Singapore. And this year, we upgraded our race, local G1. And then by last year, the highest prize money was about 700,000 US of the Korean President Cup. But now, the Korea Sprint is 700,000 US, and then we will host the first ever $1 million Korea Cup. The race condition will be 1,800 meter. And try to invite horses all from seven countries. And I like to develop our international race, IG3 and eventually IG1. But it's a very difficult and long and winding, it will be very long and winding road, but the small possibility makes dreams come true. From this experience, I got to know this kind of a wording into my life. Thank you very much.